This is about a collection of documents, which you can see in the boxes, but it's also a computer index, which gives you not only access to the documents here, but it's an index to the other collections in other archives or in government records, things like that. And the special feature is that the search terms are arranged in game management fashion, so that if you go to a state library or anything, they have search terms which are all about everything except your very specialised study, which is game management. And I've limited the material at this stage just to the 19th century and also the 20th century up to 1980. That was the period that I was most active in Victoria. And it was also the stage when there was tremendous public support for example, a game license and for all game management work. And I've seen the public interest, if we could call it that, gradually decline over the subsequent years, so that I'm suggesting that one way we can bring that interest back is to demonstrate that hunting and game management in particular was an activity carried on by the community even before they recognised that it was especially about ecology and wildlife habits. In other words, the Aborigines had a method of providing the best hunting in some of the plains country. The early settlers talked about game parks and special reserves and sanctuaries for game. They all had, and also they tried to introduce game laws. These were mainly on paper, so that even though they were perhaps ineffective, they illustrated a very intrinsic desire by the community to look after wildlife and game particularly. And so we can trace through the several hundred years quite a picture of how community activities have evolved. That's what the National Hunting Archive is about, the study of game management by the community. And this, of course, is not a competitor with ecological work that's going on with various places and which has very sophisticated search systems to find out information. But this embryonic system will be the first time that anyone in Australia has concentrated on the community action for game management and conservation.
Max, this is a very impressive collection. How many volumes do you have in this collection now, and who will get access to it?
Yes, there's about 4,000 books and about 5,000 documents. Then on the index, there's about another 20,000-30,000 from the 19th century and up to 1980, which should be added to the collection or copies added. And in particular, I think we should get the records from the Australian hunters. We've lost all much of the stuff from the 19th century, but there's a lot of old hunters from the 1950s and 1960s who are still around, and maybe they have records of how they went hunting and what success the bags they had. Mm-hmm. Quite often these are not considered very important and are not collected by other institutions, but the archive, the hunting archive, would be the very valuable place for them. And of course the other thing is that the records of existing clubs, game clubs, which are present go lost, or go anywhere and lost eventually, they could be deposited here, and that's the appropriate place. There's just it's possibilities are endless. Mm. But behind it all is the thought that that this, a knowledge of our past, is not only important for designing game management programs, but it's also part of the ecology and the environmental history. We don't know that. We don't recognise that at present, and it's essential for designing the game management programs for the future.
David, this is a partnership with Field and Game, is that correct, that your ADA is partnered with Field and Game? And
yeah, I think we both see the value in it, and both happy to be a part of preserving it for future generations.
Yeah,
I commend you for it. It's very impressive and I think very worthwhile.
Right.
Who will have access to this collection, either the online or the computer?
Right now, when it's being set up, the access is very limited, mm-hmm. primarily just because it's so difficult to use. But with proper technical assistance, you could put it onto all the material. It's vital point here that all the material goes into a game management archive, a database. It's the database is a electronic record of all the topics and authors, subjects, and that can be downloaded in any analysis system with the technical facilities, so that it will eventually be available to hunters or to the public, but it's at this stage when we're just collecting material, it's not available.